Parshas Vaera, Moshe Rabbeinu continues in his leadership of Klal Yisrael, not only as an advocate for Am Yisrael, in appealing to Paro and to the Mitzrim, as a shliach, as a messenger of Hashem, in order to attain the freedom of the Jewish people, but Moshe Rabbeinu had another mandate as a leader as well. And that is to inspire a certain sense of confidence, a certain heightened morale amongst Klal Yisrael, that they will ultimately emerge from Shibud Mitzrayim and become the regal nation that Moshe Rabbeinu knows they can be. And the Torah tells us that HaKadosh Baruch Hu provides Moshe at the beginning of this week's parasha with a number of formulations of redemption to convey to the Jewish people. V'hotseisi, v'hitzalti, I'm going to take you out, I'm going to save you, v'ga'alti, I'm going to redeem you, v'lakachtai, I'm going to take you as a nation, v'hevesi, I'm going to bring you to Eretz Yisrael. And we would expect that the reaction of Am Yisrael after so many years in this world of Mitzrayim, in this world of servitude, will be to embrace this vision of redemption and freedom. But the Torah says that the reaction of the Jewish people is v'lo shamu el Moshe. They could not even hear what Moshe was saying. Mikotzer ruach, because their spirit was cut off, u'me'avoda kasha, and from the oppressive nature of the servitude itself. And the Rishonim ask, what was it about Moshe Rabbeinu's message that was so difficult for Am Yisrael to internalize? It's the message they wanted to hear. It's the message that any slave would want to hear. It's the message of freedom. It's the message of hope. What is it that was such a barrier to those words, to those formulations, penetrating the consciousness of the Jewish people and elevating them with a sense of hope and confidence? Explain some of the Mefarshim that the Jewish people were just so immersed in their world of servitude, the exhaustion was just so all-consuming. They had no patience to relate to this complex, multifaceted, nuanced message of redemption. Rashab Shafal Hirsch writes, it's the fact that it was incremental. They couldn't handle stages. You want to tell us that you're going to come in and grab us out of Mitzrayim and take us to a new life? Great. Hotseisi, hitzalti, ga'alti, lakachti, v'hevesi. It was just too overwhelming for a nation that had become so defined by their experience. The Meshech Chachma relates a little bit of a different interpretation. Explains the Meshech Chachma that what really was going on here was that when Moshe Rabbeinu approaches Am Yisrael with the vision for Geula, a vision that included not only the emancipation from Mitzrayim, but also ultimately the mandate to build their own land, their own country, with independence and a certain sense of a value system that they were going to share with the rest of the world. When Klal Yisrael heard this, when Klal Yisrael heard that what was expected of them was not just to walk out of Mitzrayim and out of their nightmare of slavery, but that they were going to create something new, that they were going to create an entire nation that would bring to the world a level of impact and influence of what the Ribon Shalom's Torah stands for. When Moshe Rabbeinu depicted such a grandiose vision, Lo Shamu El Moshe Mikotzer Ruach U'me'avoda Kasha, Klal Yisrael had become so defined by their slave mentality. Klal Yisrael had become so defined by their victimhood. The challenges had seeped in to their consciousness, to their mindset, to their way of life, to their way of thinking, to their way of thinking about themselves, that when Moshe Rabbeinu came to them with anything past Hotseisi, and Moshe said, not only am I going to take you out, there's going to be a Torah, and there's going to be a Beis HaMikdash, and there's going to be an Eretz Yisrael, and you're going to be an Orel HaGoyim. When Moshe depicted this vision for Klal Yisrael, Lo Shamu El Moshe Mikotzer Ruach Me'avoda Kasha. It's so challenging whenever we face circumstances in life that are compromising. So they are compromising on two levels. One is the challenge itself, just contending with whatever it is that the challenge presents to our ability to function, to our ability to thrive, to our ability to move forward, whatever manner in which it restricts and restrains our functioning and our our ability for advancement. But there's another level that challenge exists at as well. Because to the first level, all we crave is relief. But the deeper level is when the challenge becomes part of who we are. When we internalize it and begin to define ourselves based on it. And that starts to erode our sense of confidence and our sense of hope. And an ability to see a vision that transcends the circumstances in front of us. And an ability to see an alternative reality within which this servitude or this challenge is no longer the defining experience of our life. And this is something that we all contend with, certainly as we are struggling with so many of the challenges surrounding our own avdus, the own aspect of our lives that have certainly held us back, restrained us, and made life very complex and very difficult and very challenging. Yes, those challenges are real. And yes, we need a hotseisi and a hitzalti in order to be able to live our lives with freedom and with an opportunity to be able to embrace the meaning that we want. Yes, we need the Rabbono Shel Olam to deal with these challenges in a manner that we can really reclaim that sense of stability and calm and capacity to be able to move forward in the way that we want. But there's another dimension, and that is the ability to not allow ourselves to internalize the challenges to the point that even when the vision is put right in front of us, we can't even see a good thing. V'lo shamu el Moshe mikotzer ruach u'me'avoda kasha. No matter how difficult life gets, we have to hold on to that inner sense of confidence and hope that HaKadosh Baruch Hu puts us in a Mitzrayim because he's trying to fashion us into something greater. Because there's greatness ahead. There's joy ahead. There's redemption ahead. There's opportunity ahead. Not just for survival, but for impact and influence and ultimately to make a difference in the rest of the world. And Be'ezras Hashem, if we can adjust that perspective, then when we are presented with opportunities to advance ourselves, our families, our communities, with new initiatives and new programs and new chances to grow and new opportunities to contribute and new chances to be able to build and to make a better world for ourselves and for our community and for our future, we'll be able to be Shamu El Moshe. We'll be able to hear it. We'll be able to internalize it. And it'll become part of our reality and animate everything we do. Have a wonderful and an amazing Shabbos.